As I've expanded the size of my garden, I have started to notice that my transfer water pump cannot deliver the necessary water pressure to my PVC drip irrigation system and other zones of my garden at the same time. This issue forced me to figure out a balanced valve adjustment for each watering zone to ensure each plant received the correct amount of water. While this method has worked for the most part, it is still quite tricky and frustrating to carry out. So I figured it was time for a water pump upgrade, and I figured I would bring you along for the journey, so let's jump right into it. Before uninstalling my current water pump, I disconnected the breaker that feeds power to the pump. After removing the old water transfer pump from the system, I began to prep the new on-demand water pump for the comparison test. Now, there are a few differences between these two pumps, but one of the primary differences between an on-demand pump and a transfer pump is the on-demand pump has a built-in water pressure switch that will automatically shut power off to the pump when activated. For those unsure what this means or looks like, don't worry, I will show an example of how this works later in the video. I added Teflon tape around the threads of the fitting to help create a watertight seal. Note, for any fittings that require Teflon tape, I usually wrap the threads about 3 to 4 times. If you enjoy these types of videos, let me know by pressing the like button and subscribing, as it helps to inform others about this channel and it also motivates me to continue to spend my time making these videos. After connecting all the necessary fittings to the on-demand pump, I began to set up my testing area. Also, I used a spare 12-volt battery to power both pumps temporarily. For my comparison test, I started with the transfer pump and I temporarily connected my rain barrel system to the inflow port on the pump and then attached a watering nozzle to the outflow port. Once everything was connected, I opened the valve for my rain barrel system. Since the transfer pump should not be running with the outflow path closed off, I went ahead and pulled the watering nozzle's rear trigger and turned on the pump's power switch to perform a spray distance test. As a quick example, since the transfer pump does not have a water pressure switch built in like the on-demand pump, if I release the trigger on the watering nozzle, you will notice the transfer pump would not turn off automatically. If the pump is left in this state for too long, you can risk damaging your pump. Next, I carried out the same test for the on-demand pump. I was impressed by how much more pressure the on-demand pump delivered compared to the transfer pump. Also, since the on-demand pump has a built-in water pressure switch, if I release the trigger on the watering nozzle, you will notice the pump would turn off automatically. If I pull the trigger again, the pump will sense the pressure drop and allow the pump to turn back on again. So an on-demand pump is a great option for those who prefer to leave power connected to the pump and have the pump automatically turn on and off based on the water demand. In my case, I never block or close off the water flow to my garden, so the on-demand feature this pump includes is not something I will be taking advantage of. My reason for upgrading to this pump is because of the increased water pressure it provides. Since I know others have asked in the past or sometimes use their rain barrel system to help water their grass, I hooked up my sprinkler and performed a test with both pumps to compare the differences. Once I was convinced that the new pump would fit my needs, I began taking some rough measurements to figure out how I will position the pump in the tote and how I may route the PVC connection. I then began installing the necessary fittings to connect the pump to my garden's watering system. I decided it may be helpful to build a basic platform out of wooden scraps for the pump to mount to, but it would require me to modify the PVC layout some in the tote. Depending on your application, this may not be necessary. At the last minute, I decided to add some metal corner braces to the platform so that I could anchor it to the wooden base below the tote. I then started preparing the PVC connection for the new pump position. Note, I used single step PVC cement to fuse my PVC fittings, and to keep the video shorter, I did not show myself adding cement to every fitting or PVC pipe. Make sure when you are attaching the PVC components to slightly turn one of the components a quarter of a turn and hold the fittings together for a few seconds to prevent pipe pushout. To connect the pump's outflow port to the PVC pipe, I use reinforced PVC vinyl tubing due to its flexibility and to reduce some of the PVC work I would need to do. I installed a barbed garden hose adapter using an adjustable clamp to ease disconnecting the pump from the system if I ever needed to. Also, make sure the barbed portion of the fitting is fully inserted into the vinyl tubing. Before connecting the vinyl tubing to the pump, I reconnected my grounding wire. Depending on this application, this may be optional, but if you are not sure, be sure to consult with a certified electrician. Once my grounding wire was connected, I connected my vinyl tubing to the pump and PVC connection. I then connected my rain barrel system to the pump's inflow port. Once all my water connections were connected, I fastened the pump down to the wooden base using some exterior wood screws. I then screwed down the pump's wooden base to the tote's wooden platform. Afterwards, I began working on the power connection to the pump. To prevent having to modify the included cable with the pump, I purchased an extension SAE cable and modified it so that I could connect one end to the pump's SAE cable and wire the other end to the battery power source wires in the tote. After all the electrical connections were made, I cleaned things up a little and zip-tied my wire connections. Since this new pump requires more power, I replaced my 10-amp DC breaker that is connected to the pump with a 20-amp breaker. Note, the pump does come with an inline 20-amp fuse, but I prefer using a DC breaker so I do not have to keep several spare fuses on hand if the fuse ever did blow. For now, I am going to leave the inline fuse and will probably bypass it at a later date. I then opened my rain barrel's outflow ball valve to prepare to test the system. However, I soon realized that since my own demand pump was a diaphragm pump, even though the pump was still powered off, it allowed water to easily pass through the pump straight to my garden spigot due to my rain barrel's been installed at a higher elevation. Here you can see a basic drawing for how my PVC plumbing to my spigot is lower than my rain barrels. To correct this problem, I would need to modify my PVC plumbing to my garden spigot to be higher than my rain barrels. Another cheap and simple solution to this problem would be to install a basic hose watering timer, which has a solenoid inside that will block water from flowing to the garden until the timer is activated by the program watering schedule. I temporarily kept the watering timer connected and then remotely turned on my pump to check for leaks. I quickly noticed that I had a leak at the end of my vinyl tubing outflow connection. Another tip to know if you have a leak is if the pump is cycling on and off within just a few seconds. Once the leak issues were fixed, I quickly tested the watering system using the watering timer. Now, as I mentioned before, this watering method could solve my issue. However, it requires that I leave power connected to my own demand pump 24/7 and rely 100% on the built-in pressure switch to turn the pump on and off. From my research for other own demand pumps, I have found that several people have complained about the built-in pressure switches failing over time, which could result in the pump attempting to pump water when the outflow path is closed or blocked. This could eventually damage the pump. Now, this pump I purchased had great reviews, and I did not see any or many reviews mentioning issues with the pressure switch. However, I just prefer not to take the risk. So instead, I decided to redo my PVC plumbing so I could continue to remotely control my pump from my phone and create my own schedule using the smartphone app. If you would like to learn more about how I set up this simple wireless feature for my pump, I will leave a video link in the description below. Before I continue with the PVC modification, I wanted to quickly test that the new PVC plumbing height was higher than the rain barrels. Since water will seek its own level, I thought it would be a fun idea to use my endoscope to check where the water level currently was in the PVC pipe. From this test, I would say the water was about a foot and a half below the top of the PVC pipe. Since the water level test passed, I continued forward with the PVC modification, not knowing that I would soon run into another issue that I had not considered. On the end of the PVC connection, I decided to change things up and connect a four-way water shutoff since I never used the old spigot's wheel handle to turn off water for my garden. To provide more access to connect other components to the four-way water shutoff, I placed some wood behind the PVC pipe to serve as a spacer. To increase the longevity of my PVC connections, I used 120 grit sandpaper to scratch up the PVC surface to prepare the components for painting. Afterwards, I quickly tested the system to see if there were any issues. When I turned the pump off, I noticed the water flow did not stop. After scratching my head some, I soon realized my system was now siphoning water from my rain barrels, which would eventually drain all the water from my barrels unless I either manually closed off the flow of water or figured out a way to allow air to enter the PVC pipe. After spending about 30 minutes to an hour researching ways to prevent this problem, I learned that there may indeed be a way to fix this, which I will show you shortly, but it would require me to make a slight adjustment to my PVC water connection. So the device that I stumbled upon that can correct this siphoning issue is called a vacuum relief valve. It is typically found on water heaters, but I learned others have used it for similar applications like mine. This device basically allows air to enter into the PVC piping system to prevent vacuum conditions that could siphon water from my rain barrels. It is also important to install the relief valve at the highest point in the piping system for it to work correctly. So after the vacuum relief valve was installed, I tested the system for the third and hopefully last time. When I turned the pump off, I was excited to see that there was no longer a siphoning occurring. I then went ahead and reconnected my drip irrigation system to the rain barrel system to make sure everything was working properly. Overall, this has been a project that I have learned quite a bit from, as well as a fun one. I could definitely tell the new pump was delivering a lot more water pressure to my garden, which made adjusting the amount of water to each raised bed much easier. The obvious reminder I learned from this project was to not give up and don't be afraid to make mistakes. If you use any type of water pump with your rain barrel or rain collection system, let me know in the comments. Also, if you found this video useful or think others might, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe. Until next time, thanks for watching.